Hello students of class 6th, this presentation is on the subject maths for knowing our numbers, that is your first chapter. Although I've already sent you a video of mine on the same topic, but I think the material I've shown you, the written material I've shown you in that video was not quite clear. So I've prepared another video in the form of presentation so that it is more clear to you guys. So let's start. Let's start with the greatest and the smallest number. If I give you certain digits and I ask you to form the greatest and the smallest number, what will you do? For example, you can see on your screen, I have shown four digits, that is 3, 4, 7, and 1. Now, if I'll ask you to form the greatest number using these digits, what will you do? You don't have to do much, just arrange them in ascending order as I have done it. I have written 7, 4, 3, 1. So the number formed is 7431, and this is the greatest number we can form using these digits. Then if I'll ask you to form the smallest number using the same digits, what will you do? You will arrange these digits in descending order as I have done. 1, 3, 4, 7, and the number formed is 1347, which is the smallest number we can form using the digits 3, 4, 7, and 1. So to form the greatest number using the digits, we arrange them in ascending order, and for smallest number, we arrange them in descending order. Okay, students, you can see two pictures on your screen, right? Okay, look at the upper half picture. What can you see? You can see that there is a thief holding a bag in his hand and he's running away from the police, and the policeman is trying to catch him. Okay, what happens? This thief is having a lot of amount of money in his bag and he's trying to escape from the police, and he succeeds in that. And after escaping from the police, he reaches to his boss, as you can see in the next half of the picture. He reaches to his boss. Now the boss asks him, how much money have you got in the bag? The thief said, sir, around I've got 1 crore rupees or 20 crore rupees. If he says so, so then the thief is an Indian thief. If he says that, sir, it's around 1 million or 2 million or 20 million, then the thief is a foreigner. Why I am telling you this, foreigner and Indian? When the thief is saying, I have got 10 crore, that means he is giving the amount in Indian system of numeration. So let's come to Indian system of numeration. Two things are very important in this. First is the place value and second is the comma. You can see a table on your screen, right? What are the periods? Periods are crores, lakhs, thousands, ones. That is mentioned in the table. And what will be the place values? 10 crore, crore for the crore period, 10 lakh, lakh for the lakhs period, 10,000, thousand for the thousand period, and 100 tens, ones for the ones period. Right? This is according to the Indian system of numeration, that is ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh crore, 10 crore. Okay, now second important thing which I told you is how to place the commas. This is important, very important. Most of us don't take it seriously to place the commas, but it is very important, and we should know how to place the commas while writing a number. So we place the commas to the given number according to the periods. That is, we will start from ones, tens, hundreds, and then we will put a comma, as I have placed the comma over here after counting from 3, 2, 4, then I have placed the comma. Then move on to 5, 1, that is the thousand period is complete, we will put another comma. Then 6, 9, that is lakhs period is complete, so we'll put a comma over here. Then 8 and 2, but now we will not place any comma over here because we never start a number with a comma. So we will leave it as it is. Now the number, I have written it in a precise form, 28, 96, 15, 423. And how will I read this number? How will I read it out? I will read it out 28,96,15,423. How will I read it? 28,96,15,423. So I told you that the thief told his boss that I have got around 20 crore or 2 crore or 35 crore. The thief is Indian and he is giving the amount according to Indian system of numeration. Now let's start with the international system of numeration. Now if the thief is telling his boss that I have got around 20 million or 30 million in my bag, so he is a foreigner and he is giving the amount of money according to international system of numeration that is used internationally. Again, in this system also, two things are very important. First is the place values and second is the commas. The same thing that was important in Indian system of numeration. So here there is a difference. What is the difference? There is a difference between periods and places. What we were using in Indian system of numeration, we are not going to use it over here. Some things are similar, but the other things are different. So we'll start with ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, 100,000. Then million, 10 million, 100 million. Okay, till thousand place, it is same. Ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000. It was absolutely same as it was in Indian system of numeration, but after that, it changed. Here also, we put the commas according to the periods. That is, here the number is written 7986541 3 2. So I'll start with the ones place 2 3 1. Once place is over, I'll place the comma. Then 4 5 6. Thousand period is complete, so I'll put the comma. Then 8 9 7. These three are for million periods, but we are not going to place the comma now because we never start a number using a comma. Now I have written it in a precise form again, 7986541 3 2. And how will I read it out this number? I will read it out as 798,654,132. I hope it is clear to you that what is the difference between Indian system of numeration and international system of numeration. Okay, here I have given some examples. You can go through them. It's place commas correctly and write the numerals. First one is 73,75,307. Okay, there is lakh in it. That means it is Indian system of numeration because we don't have lakh in international system of numeration. So how will we write this number in numerals? Look at it. I have given it in the form of a table. It is written that first we will form the table crore, 10 lakh, lakh, 10,000, 1,000, 100, tens and ones. And then we will place our digits. Okay, it is written over here 73 lakh. That means two places are filled with 73. That is a lakh period is filled up. Then we have 75,000. Again, 75. Two places for 1,000 filled up. Then we have 307. That means how do we write 307? 307, right? We don't have anything at tens place, so we will write 0 at tens place. So it is 307. Next we'll move on to 58,423,202. This is according to the international system of numeration. We will form the table accordingly at ones place, ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000, 100,000 million, 10 million and 100 million. So 58 million, 58 is filled up, 423 is filled up with a 1,000 period and 202 is filled up with 1's period. Thank you, students. I hope this is clear to you now. It is more clear than before, because I know there is a difference between what we can see on the screen and what I speak. So students, I'll be giving you homework on this. Do it. Thank you so much.